Greetings, saints, and grace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm Pastor Billy D. Welcome to another Moments in Ministry. Genesis 1:4, "And God separated the light from the darkness," speaks of an internal disagreement. A believer has two principles at work within him. In his natural state, he was subject to one principle only, which was darkness. Now light has entered, and the two principles disagree. Consider the Apostle Paul's words in the 7th chapter of Romans. "I find it to be a law that when I want to do right, evil lies close at hand. For I delight in the law of God in my inner being, but I see in my members another law raging war against the law of my mind and making me captive to the law of sin that dwells in my members." How is this state of things occasioned? God separated the light from the darkness. Darkness by itself is quiet and undisturbed. But when the Lord sends in light, there is a conflict, for the one is in opposition with the other, a conflict that will never end until the believer is altogether light in the Lord. If there is a division inside the individual Christian, there is certain to be a division outside. As soon as the Lord gives light to any man, he proceeds to separate himself from the darkness around. He withdraws from a merely worldly religion of outward ceremony, for nothing short of the glory of Christ will now satisfy him. And he removes himself from worldly society, frivolous amusements, and seeks the company of the saints. For we know that we have passed out of death into life because we love the brothers. The light gathers to itself and the darkness to itself. What God has separated, never let us try to unite. But as Christ went outside the camp, bearing his reproach, let us come out from the ungodly and be a special people. He was holy, harmless, undefiled, separate from sinners, and as he was, so we are to be nonconformists to the world. Dissenting from all sin and distinguished from the rest of mankind by our likeness to our Master. Here's a slice of today's bread of heaven from Zechariah 10:1. "Ask ye of the Lord rain in the time of the latter rain, so the Lord shall make bright clouds and give them showers of rain to every one grass in the field." Let us pray. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. So until we come this way again, may God bless you and keep you, is my prayer.